So I have this click now, which gives me a random law of attraction story. Let's look at some of these. So this story here shows that a sigh of relief is an effective technique. And when I was very young, and dabbling in Christian aesthetics, I heard that when a prayer is accompanied by sigh, it is a good sign. It means that the prayer was likely have been heard and was likely to be fulfilled in some way. So I've known of the significance of a sigh for a long time now, and I've been looking ever since for any clues as to why it might work. And I've been going through some experiments of my own design based on Sobbing Breath by Yuri Vilnas. And there is, of course, this book, Yoga Skills for Therapists. But what is interesting to point out is that in this park in the machine by Daniel Kern, we have this chapter about the lung. So here Kern reminds us of the fractal recursion in the body. So the body have a lot of recursive fractal systems, where the ear, for example, is mapped over the body. So here we see this homunculus. And we can trace experimentally the relationship of these points to different subsystems of the body. And it's this kind of fractal connection exists also in the neck, in the hands, feet and other places. Such fractal reflections are called microsystems, I think. So here, Kion points that lungs have a kind of such reflection as well. It's like a tree within a tree. He points also that the lungs can grow on their own, extracted from the body, they can grow on their own and are only connected to the body through the voice box. So we have many brains throughout the body. Agulov likes to point that the stomach is another kind of a brain, that there is a lot of neural tissue in the stomach, in the organs there. But we see that the lungs are also a brain of their own. It's a subsystem which might have a mind of its own. So skin, brain and skin develop from the same embryogenic layer. Some Western researchers point out that we think not just with our brain, but also with our skin, which makes a certain sense because skin is what we use to interact with the outer world. And there are cases where psychological problems are resolved by some physiological effect on the skin. And so I might think of the lungs as a kind of a skin layer which touches both the blood coming from the heart, filters the blood from the heart, and also touches the air. So it's a really touchy, a huge field of skin which touches both inside and outside, a huge sensory organ. And Kion hints that lungs are somehow connected to inspiration, maybe through the thyroid. He wouldn't draw a specific connection to inspiration, but he hints that it was the Eastern wisdom that the lungs are connected to inspiration, which was my point really. So there is a language connection, spirare, and inspiration is literally the same root. But he points also that higher spiritual aspects of society are linked in with chanting, breath and the lungs. He points also that the chanting and the connection with the voice box. So lungs are an important part of a verbal will. In the video I've seen recently, it tells of how avoiding a negative speak, so not speaking out the negative predictions, might be the most effective technique in training athletes in sports coaching, which might be funny. So look for yourself, because it's like this this trick, this very effective trick, which you wouldn't expect because it is so simple and obvious, but it is nevertheless the most effective trick. It's simply never to speak out some negative predictions. So if you want to have another go at Morozko, then this podcast here might give you a key. So the verbal will deciding what we are to say about the future and about ourselves. Lungs are instrumental in all of this. They give the power to our speech, to our verbal and social decision making. But they are also a huge and independent subsystem, independent country within our body, a huge number of cells with a mind of their own. So the nanofilm of the lungs is, in a sense, an upside down tree. In the tree, The surface allows us to capture allows the trees to capture sunlight and convert it into energy, and the lungs similarly capture the energy from the air. And the tricks the tree and the lungs use to produce energy are similar in some way. So the lungs are best thought of as an extremely delicate, extremely beautiful gossamer leaf tree sitting upside down and submerged in a pool of blood. The lungs are therefore almost more blood than the lung. Connection of earthly nature to something ephemeral, such as sunlight or air. Kyon also points elsewhere that our body is separated into these subsystems by fascia. So lungs are in the same fascia box with the voice, essentially. And these Lego blocks of the fascia, they're not just barriers, but they also influence how the information flows through the body. So lungs are connected to voice in more than just one way. So thyroid glands are like a metabolic thermostat, turn them up, and all the cells in your body work faster. Too fast and you become manic. Too slow and you never want to get out of bed. And this is all connected to lungs. So again, this is linked to inspiration. So it's like funding. We have maybe some idea, but it's another thing whether someone would fund it with energy from the air, with thyroid upregulation, or maybe someone will break down on it. So let me assume, sum this up up here. Sparking machine, lungs are intimately connected to production of energy from the air, to generic up-down regulation of activity in thyroids, and the voice. And to the voice. They are, in a sense, a key maker behind the verbal will. In low production, the lungs are engaged, for instance, with a sigh of relief.